The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Power Trading Hour with your host, David White. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, David White.
And welcome all to another exciting edition of the Power Trading Hour. Whether you're in Brunei, Chennai, Dubai, or Mumbai, we love to come to you each and every trading day at this time.
The following takes place between 2 p.m. and 3 p.m.
So what do we have? Apples. Am I there? Got a little bit. Apple down a little bit off of its highs, a little anticlimactic. Everybody was expecting one more thing. Still positive on the day by 40 cents, but not down. But it's been hammered on the short side from the earlier morning. My guess is it continues to move up a little bit. Interesting presentation, some new sensors for blood oxygen, some other stuff for the watch, a better looking display, and faster graphics for the iPad. That's kind of it. You're always expecting something a lot more from them, but it's kind of anticlimactic. My guess, though, is everybody will look past this in another 5 minutes and look on to the Fed and then look on to the next iPhone, which I guess we're going to have another presentation in another 30 days on it. So fairly close. But I think a lot of people were looking for the smartwatch maybe to have a killer feature like being able to tell your glucose level. We discussed that in the den today. But nothing such as that. But that's about it. Anyway, probably going to come down a little bit. Apple moves the market. It's 115.52. For the rest of the stuff, though, I think it's probably going to be fairly quickly forgotten. All the IPOs are coming. We've talked that Thursday for Snowflake and Unity. Bears are going all in at these levels, pretty high daily levels of shorting. Expiration, of course, is on the 18th, and the Fed tomorrow, and Apple's show actually today. I forgot to change that, so we will do that. So I will edit it out, but probably less than exciting. I don't see a lot of downside on this. Maybe it could get a little bit momentum of everybody selling, but my guess is it burns out fairly quick. What else do we have? That's kind of it. Kind of quiet on the day. And we'll see what else happens out here. But certainly Apple 115s, 116s. Historically, after one of these, we probably should see Apple at about 120 on the close today. So anything lower than that is kind of a, at least I'm going to score it in the miss column for Apple and their dog and pony shows. What else is out there? Anyway, volume, about what it was on the way down. It's about what it is on the way up. We have 5.5 billion shares on the CBOE consolidated tape as we speak. And of course, pretty much been up since this morning and still up 21 points on the S&P. Dow's up 59, NASDAQ's still up 130, even with Apple doing a little bit of reversal, but looks to me more like Apple may end up flat on the day to maybe slightly higher, maybe 116s or so, once the shorts give up on trying to beat it down. They tried that last week. Generally, that doesn't just come back almost instantly. Give me a call at 877-927-6648. You can always email me at path@tfnn.com. And, of course, you can always put a message in the den, as some have. So not anything truly exciting in Apple's position. So let's go to a little history, and then we'll go on. Got a lot of charts to look at.
And it's all just a little bit of history repeating.
On this day in 2008, the venerable Wall Street brokerage Lehman Brothers seeks Chapter 11 bankruptcy protection, becoming the largest victim of the subprime mortgage crisis that would devastate financial markets, contribute to the biggest economic downturn since the Great Depression. Of course, this was a decision made at the highest levels of government. And that decision was to let Lehman Brothers go belly up, and that would teach everybody else the lesson. And of course, all it did was spread the contagion everywhere made it much worse. When we look at what happens today and everybody decries the intervention of the Fed and the Treasury in daily operations, we can go back to this day when they made a mistake. Probably making a mistake going too far the other way, but when they can't sleep at night, it goes back to this day when they made that tragic mistake not to let the air out of the balloon slowly. And if there's one thing that the Fed and Treasury are all in on, is whatever happens, don't let it get out of control. Don't let momentum get to the point where you can't stop it. That was the mistake this day in September 15th, 2008. Of course, I learned a fairly good lesson out of it. This is the second big downturn since I'd gone full-time trading in 1998. John Bogle's quote here always makes me think, "Your success in investing will depend in part on your character and guts, and in your part on your ability to realize that the height of ebullience and the depth of despair alike, that this too shall pass." And you know what? September, by March, the first week of March 2009, I was about to make the most money I'd ever made in the market on equities, not on options, by buying stocks somewhere around March 5th, March 9th of 2009 that had tested previous lows on not half volume, not even 25%. I was end up buying a bunch of stocks that were testing previous lows on 10, 15% of the volume of 3 months before. And what can you say about it? Well, it's led me to the way I trade now, and that is that I'm always looking for not just minor changes in fluctuation in volume, but massive changes in volume. I kind of start off looking for volume decreasing by 50% on highs and lows, and that's made all the difference in the world. And, of course, we've been able to buy, at least for the last few years, be able to buy, I think, 8 of the 9 major lows that we could have found big money off of because of my sector oscillators. So pretty much everything that we had, I got 1 stock out of 8 that's lower on the day. But pretty good showing for both the Tech Insider and the Path of Least Resistance today. You can check them out on the front page of TFNN.
If you're not currently using the TAS Profile Scanner when looking at setting up your trading opportunities, then your arsenal is short a mighty weapon. The TAS Profile Scanner is a standalone piece of software that instantly filters over 2,500 global financial markets such as stocks, ETFs, commodity futures, and Forex. Headed by Steve Dahl, TAS understands that in today's technological world, the use of top-flight software applications and technical analysis expertise is essential to successful trading in today's market. You also gain access to the webinar that Steve Dahl and Tom O'Brien just hosted, The Best Way to Use the TAS Profile Scanner to Profit. This webinar archive is available for all subscribers immediately upon signing up. All new subscriptions also come with a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Start your subscription by visiting the front page of TFNN.com today, and you'll find the TAS Profile Scanner under the Services tab. Sign up today. Are you in the market for buying or selling real estate in the Bay Area, including the surrounding St. Petersburg, Tampa, and Clearwater markets? Tiger Real Estate LLC is a firm that has extensive experience in the Tampa Bay Area. Whether you're looking to sell your current property for maximum value, or you're in the market for a second home or investment property, Tiger Realty has the experience across all areas of real estate in the Tampa Bay area to help buyers and sellers make the most informed decisions across all price levels. From the price you should be paying per square foot in certain up-and-coming areas to the type of cash flow investment properties are capable of creating, Tiger Real Estate can help you make the best decision when it comes to all areas of the market. Before you make one of the biggest decisions of your financial future, call Tiger Real Estate LLC today at 727-329-8322 or email us at tiger@tfnn.com. That's 727-329-8322. Call us today.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
We're going to look at those stocks that seem to be a little more exciting or giving maybe some clues. Light volume breaks of highs and lows. AC Immune in the bio sector had a nice day yesterday, but nothing in the way of volume. About half the volume of the August 21st high. ACIU for the symbol on that one. ADMS, which is Adamas Pharmaceuticals, had a huge move off the top two huge candles back on the 7th and 10th of August. About 6.8 million shares on that day. Got back into it yesterday with a little hammer candle, about 224,000 shares. So, as I said, a lot of these stocks back down into these previous signs of strength with incredibly light volume. I'd keep an eye on this one. ADMS. Okay. Some of these other ones. Can't remember why I actually had, oh, here it is. Maybe a little longer time frame. This one's interesting in that it's broken the previous June 5th high, 18 million shares. This is AGNC Investment Corp. AGNC is the symbol. 18 million shares on June 5th. Got into it yesterday with half that, 7.5 million shares. Only about 3.5 million shares so far. Some of these things look like they're going to go back into the trading range. On the positive side, no volume or lighter volume, let me put it that way. And Alexander and Baldwin. I'm wondering, is this the piano company? I'm thinking this is what this thing is, isn't it? Baldwin? Premier real estate company and largest owner of grocery anchored neighborhood shopping centers. Well, I was wrong on that. Anyway, 400,000 shares back on June 24th at 11:17. Got into it, as I said, with basically 75% of the volume. Popped right back into the trading range. Little hammer candle out here today. Real estate in Hawaii. Well, that makes sense. to AMBAC Financial, AMBC. Now, this is very tasty looking today. If you're looking for new positions, great looking chart. May 13th, $11.60. What's called 1.4 million shares. Yesterday, 400,000 shares. Today, spiked that. Looks like it could close back above it with 141,000 shares. To AMG, affiliated manager group, basically pulling back to support. I don't see a lot of clear signals on that. AMH, retesting the highs. This is America Homes for Rent. AMH, the symbol again. Retesting two previous highs, the February 11th high, March 5th high. That had 4.4 million shares. Little candle out here today on 1.2 million shares so far. So keep an eye on that. Amazon did spike to 35.52. It's come back down. Volume has kind of shrunk the last 4 days. Very light volume today. You're just back into this trading range, which is really just a tad under 3,000 and back up to 33.50. Let's say that in that area. So just kind of plowing around in that area. What else do we have? ATHM, another one banging right at highs. This one on light volume on 720,000 shares on June 8th at $90.85. Got to 92.03 with 900,000 shares. Retested into it yesterday with 530. Today, about 263,000. Again, I think some of these things are just hanging out here waiting for the Fed to talk tomorrow. We'll probably have some good action off that. Astronics, ATRO, not a bad-looking chart out here if you want to buy something that has no volume at the lows. May 6th, $7.09, 620,000 shares. Got into it with 266,000 shares on July 31st. Got into it with 156,000 shares on the 11th. And just kind of gone sideways out here without much volume. And again, you're at now 791. You really want to see that 709 tested on this with lighter volume, but could just be a few days away. AWI, which is Armstrong Worldwide. I think this is a Berkshire Hathaway company, if I'm not mistaken, or they're involved in it some way. Last major low on May 14th, had a million shares, 64.39. You got to 65.56 today on 350,000 shares. Again, you got a couple other lows in the 700,000 and 950,000 shares. Maybe you get another day or two out here, but if volume does not increase, look for a significant low in that portion of the, or that sector of the market. Alterix, ordinary shares class A. This thing went to the highs, pulled back from 185.75 down to 103.92, and now just going sideways. Volume starting to come out. I still would want to see that consolidate for a few more weeks. BGCP, which is BGC Partners. Got to make sure and take a look at this one. Financial technology company, rest of the world, offers various brokerage products, fixed income, foreign exchange, equities, energy, and commodities. Well, it looks like it's starting to run out of some volume. Like to see that $2.30 of May 14th tested with lighter volume. You're almost there. Cracker Barrel, CBRL, you know, maybe the end of summer might be putting a high in on this one. Of course, summertime travel this year revolved about getting in the car because you couldn't really go anywhere. So you went other places. So they probably did fairly well. And the RV circuit probably doing well. They're outside of most large cities, so they could remain open. Anyway, June 5th, 135.28 with 1.3 million shares. Got to a high of 139.80 with 500,000 shares. It's back into this trading range. If probably back, could have, see a big range from 95.12, this July 10th low, up to that 140 area. Need to get back through the sign of strength, though, on the 27th. That low of that day, the low of that day would be, 122.96? And today's low to 128.90, definitely into that candle. And what kind of volume? Yeah, volume's pretty good, 560 so far. So, could get back into support, 125, 128, maybe something like that. Might find a low in it. Give me a call, 877-927-6648. As we go to break, look at the market already in progress.
If you're a trader in the market looking to find the path that leads to maximizing profits while decreasing risk, then now is a great time to try out Dave White's daily trading service, The Path of Least Resistance. Through the use of options and equity trades, Dave advises his subscribers on a daily basis of the current market conditions and what possible trade setups are on the horizon. The Path of Least Resistance is published every trading morning, often with updates intraday when initiating trades or closing out positions. Dave White has advised his clients of some outstanding winning options and equity trades in recent months, and now is a great time to try it out for yourself. New subscribers to the Path of Least Resistance receive a 30-day money-back guarantee. See for yourself the types of options and equity trades that are available by signing up for the Path of Least Resistance today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com and selecting the newsletter tab. Sign up today.
Hi, folks. Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Bam! Go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
And we're back. Good question in the den. Anything on my radar that would participate in S&P decline to retest 33.10, the low? Thanks in advance. Right now, there's a lot of things that could happen. I don't see anything. One of the things that, of course, is going to happen this week is IPOs. That's normally fairly bullish. We also have options expiration. That's fairly bullish. We kind of pulled back into the three-day weekend on a lot of people quit shorting the market. It was able to retreat fairly quickly. Those shorts are back. That's generally a bullish sign in the fact that markets really take their quick declines, not on lots of bearishness, but a lack of bearishness. We had that going into that last week. But from stocks like Apple and Tesla, the bears are back and piling in. Generally, that's a good sign because they'll squeeze them out before it goes lower on the whole, on the average, on the medium. But what are the things you may want to look for a sign, or at least I'll give you my signs that I'm looking at right now that would say that the market's going to roll over? That would be a real weakness in this IPO ETF, showing that this is over. I think to some degree we're being pumped up a little bit by IPO mania. That does go through next week and the 23rd for Planeteer. It is exceedingly rare that you won't see a lot of upgrades and everything, probably tomorrow, maybe Thursday. They're going to do everything they can to make sure this market does well with an abundance of shorts, kind of the equivalent of the people that won't let you clear out the firewood in California and Oregon. All you need is a spark for a fairly decent short squeeze in the market, and that's why I avoid highly shorted stocks. Anyway, up a little bit today, but my guess is this could be back up to 52, the September 2nd high for Planeteer next week. We'll see how these things roll out on Thursday, but my guess is they're going to do okay. So that's one thing I'd look at. The other thing would be a failure in the GLD. Generally, big declines are preceded by at least a couple of weeks with gold going lower. Just looks to me like a trading range right now between 180 and 189 in the GLD. And my guess is this being a little bit of a roll off the top, but no volume today. We're probably at least going to get into this candle in the high of the 1st of September and more likely that August 18th high. And if volume starts coming in, we could go back to the highs. I'd be much more reticent to think of downtrends when this starts acting horribly. It has not so far. The other thing I would say is when the UVXY starts heading higher with a stationary VIX component, that's yet another clue that maybe we found some kind of high. I don't see it quite yet. Does it go a lot lower from here? Probably not, but I mean in the next few days. Friday probably gets decimated and breaks the 1875 low, though, which is the August 26th low, and breaks lower. They'll reverse split this out. And by the way, this is one of those particular ETFs that in about 300 days will go from whatever it is to zero, just on the decay underlying the action in it. So just be prepared for this thing, even if we just go sideways, to have kind of more decay in it. Okay. Hopefully that answers those questions. Email me at path@tfnn.com. And of course, you can always put a message in the den. Okay. 305 on the S&P cash, up 65 on the Dow, NASDAQ up 131. We're going into the Fed tomorrow, and of course, going to probably see a lot of volume early from maybe the open till about 11. Then we'll be on kind of light volume all the way until they announce it too and get over with the presser, which generally ends around 315, 330. Let's take a look at that. CIT Group, pretty nice low volume test out here in the last few days, July 21st, $17.56. with 4.4 million shares, got into that, went below it by a penny, closed back above it. That was on Friday. You had 1.5 million shares to the 4.4 million shares. So certainly a fairly nice one. Energy has continued to pull back. You might get a few more days of sideways. This may even go in to October before it starts moving higher. But so far, no real sign of weakness at the previous lows. 2K. What does your put call clairvoyant 8-ball on Amazon say over the next few days? This is quad witching, and I tend not to make a bunch of individual predictions when there are a lot of futures surrounding something on Friday. It's generally where it doesn't work that well. Let me see what we've got here. Just because there's so many different things going so many different ways. Yeah, I don't have anything real good on that. Short interest actually came down a little bit. Although yesterday was pretty high short, almost 20% shorts in Amazon for the day, which was pretty high. You have to go back to the 19th of August. Is that right? Yeah, 19th of August. Find a day that they shorted as much as they did. Go back here and look at it. Again, as I said, this one's kind of mushy. I think there are better stocks out here that are more predictable. But I just think this thing's probably in some kind of trading range now, up to 3,400 and down to possibly 2,900-ish out here, just kind of going sideways. Again, let me put it this way. Incredibly tough odds to short Amazon going into Christmas. Incredibly tough odds, no matter what you think out here of it. Okay, so we got that one. Got some other ones here. Take a look. Do my wallet a favor. How can I help? Okay. Okay. DeBozo, I got to cancel Christmas. Well, we can pray for the people of New York that maybe they get more enlightened leaders. Okay, what else is going on here? Oh, we're going to break. We'll be back. We've got a lot more charts to look at here today, so we will see out here. 3406 on the S&P cash. So not much else to say about that. Up 140 on the NASDAQ.
Many of our new listeners have heard about the Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive the Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on the Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
TFNN has launched our brand new website. You can still visit us at the same TFNN.com URL, but when you do, you'll see a new and improved homepage with a much simpler navigation, whether you're watching Tiger TV live in high definition or just accessing your newsletter subscriptions. We even have new pricing in 6 months and yearly options. Check out the new TFNN.com now and experience all the upgrades. TFNN.com, educating investors.
If you haven't checked out the newsletters page of TFNN.com, what are you waiting for? All of the TFNN newsletters are informative, up-to-date, affordable, and a must-have for every trader looking to gain a competitive informational edge in today's markets. TFNN newsletters cover every aspect of the markets to offer you the very latest in market news. Plus, new subscribers get to test drive our newsletters risk-free for 30 days. From all aspects of the markets, including stocks, bonds, metals, commodities, and tech, there's a newsletter to fit your needs exclusively from TFNN. Stay informed each day you trade and get that competitive edge that will help you stay ahead of the game. Visit our newsletters page by going to TFNN.com and click the newsletters button near the top of the page. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
And we had a question from Ken. About Olin, this is up about 15%, he says, since we talked last about it. You know, you had a nice sign of strength off the low. What you didn't have is significantly lighter volume. You did have lighter volume. You had 5.6 million shares at $10.12. You went below it and then rocketed back out of it with 4 million shares. Again, I'm just thinking, So, yeah, it's bouncing around. You got a 20% trading range. So maybe you can make some money on it. But this is a company that makes lots of different chemicals and cleaning products, some for guns, which is what I remember them for. I just don't think that this is one other than maybe all the gun products that will end up being a lot more out here. But just in a bigger trading range, I don't see the development, anything huge here. Okay. We have that. Okay. Lara, Lexi, by November 110 calls, what do you think? Stake is making new highs. CHRW. Nice move. I'm not a fan of buying calls anytime the VIX is above about really 16, but maybe this year I'd buy it at 18. The problem is if the time is generally going to decay before you're right. We're sitting at a VIX with in the mid 25 area today. I'm generally much more interested in buying calls and puts with a VIX below 18 and maybe 16. Then you get kind of a fighting chance if you're right for a day or two. But generally, if you can buy options when the VIX is 16, 14, 12, you've got a lot of time to be right. They're not going to decay on you. And that's what I kind of dislike. I'm a much bigger fan right now in owning actual equities. And that's pretty much everything I have is in equities now. And that's just because it can take a long time to get where you're going. You may have a nice pop here today, and we've got some nice pops in the newsletters. I just don't want to be sitting here thinking that I've got to get 2% moves out of a stock every day to outrun the option decay. And I think we still have a lot of room for options decay. You can take one step forward a day and still lose on a lot of these options now. 408 on the S&P cash. 3408 on the S&P cash, or step 25 on the day. Copa SA, so that must be South Africa, right? South America. Very light volume on this one. CPA, the symbol on this one, back into the June 16th high of 850,000 shares compared to the 300,000 shares today and the 1.3 million shares on June 9th. CPG, Crescent Point Energy. This one looks like it's coming back at enough volume. Yeah, it's penny stock. I was looking back at these big thrust up days, May 18th, but I don't know. That's not clear enough. DNLI, Denali Therapeutics, a lot of biotechs breaking out over the last couple of days. This one going through the high of the 6th of August. It had 6.3 million shares. You had 2 million shares yesterday, 306,000 shares today, though. So some of those not having the kind of juice that you want. EPRT, Essential Properties Real Estate Trust, trying to get back up in the previous high with 3.2 million shares. That's the June 5th high, $20.54. 3.2 million shares, 320,000 shares today. So maybe that's a little bit of Lennar, who had earnings out last night. Going into the Fed meeting, though, I'd probably give it a day before I make too many decisions. Extra Space Storage, EXR, going back through to the March 4th and now the February 18th highs. The March 4th high had 1.5 million shares, getting back into that with 204,000 shares. EZPW, Easy Corp. This is where this looks actually fairly good. Semi, July 10th, $5.25 with 1 million shares, got into it with 250,000 shares on September 1st. Got into it yesterday with 234,000 shares. Today, 122,000 shares on the downside. You want this thing to close back above 525 to get a signal. You don't want to be below that. But if the SMHs continue to do well, then that is something. Okay. Is there... Okay, semiconductor space. You've got at least a 50% retrace looking like it's going on here. Let's take a quick look. Okay, from the 84.61 September 2nd high to the 163.58 low, 174.09 would have been a 50%. So we're basically at that 50% retracement today on the SMHs. So maybe it gives it up before the end of the day. I don't think so. I think we're going to meander around here as we did yesterday, kind of go a little higher, see a lot of people once again short the close, only to cover it the next morning. Again, I think we're probably going to pop up, maybe get a little retracement before the Fed, but that, again, will be on light volume. Four Corners Property Trust, FCPT is the symbol on this one. 1.4 million shares back on June 5th. Let's clean that up a little bit. 1.4 million shares back on June 5th. Kind of getting into that with 108,000 shares today. So there's a lot of very thin, light volume shares out here hanging at tops. Fox Factory Holdings. This one's another one testing previous low on very light volume. Had a spike down on July 14th of 900,000 shares at $71.37. You haven't quite got there, but you're certainly in that candle with just 267,000 shares. What do these guys do? They hold factories? That's what they say they do. Let's take a quick look here. Ride Markets and Markets Ride Dynamic Product Company, front fork and rear suspension products for mountain bikes, road bikes, e-bikes. Probably not a bad business right now. The company owns, licenses, and sells Fox. Oh, Fox Racing. I didn't even know that this was the Fox. You'll see their logos on anybody that owns a dirt bike. I didn't know this is what the company was. Brazelton, Georgia. Anyway, nice looking thing out here. Hard to think that dirt bikes won't do well. Anything that avoids the public. That would be it. Going to the break, you got just a minute or two to give me a call. for the last 2 minutes of the show, 877-927-6648, or email me at path@tfnn.com.
Back in the day, I joined Hotel California in 2006, and like many of you, was drawn in by, bam! As well as,
whatever you think about, you bring about, whatever you focus on grows.
You see, I believe that everything in life happens for us, not to us, and Tom ignited the fire within me to want to learn how to master the markets. So how did I go from knowing nothing about technical analysis to becoming the number one market timer for the S&P 500 in 2018 and the number two market timer in 2019? Simply put, I hired coaches with a proven track record, which led me to a whole new set of tools that I created to interpret the message of buyers and sellers. I would love the opportunity to teach you this award-winning set of tools and help you improve your market timing. You can test drive my newsletter service, Mastering Probabilities, for the next 30 days with no risk to you. Plus, you'll gain access to archive workshops that'll take you step-by-step through my system. Sign up today by going to the homepage of TFNN.com and selecting Mastering Probability in the newsletter tab. Bam!
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and the Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your two-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
With markets trading with extreme volatility and peaks and troughs everywhere, regardless of what you're looking at in the markets, this is a great time to see the type of analysis Basil Chapman delivers for his subscribers every market day with the Opening Call newsletter. Basil has been analyzing markets, providing his take for subscribers to his trading services since 1984. Every morning, Basil publishes an update for his subscribers, along with weekend and evening updates when warranted. The Opening Call provides traders a daily market overview with regard to the direction of the key indices, selective stocks and commodities, along with specific recommendations, including stops and targets. You also gain instant access to Basil's subscriber webinar archive from earlier this year, a dark cloud cover, and essential market analysis. Ride the Chapman wave today by signing up for the Opening Call newsletter on the front page of TFNN.com under the newsletter tab. New subscribers get a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you have nothing to risk. Sign up today.
Catch Tom O'Brien, professional trader and educator, founder of TFNN, also a special guest on CNBC. Tom will bisect and dissect the markets. The Tom O'Brien Show, next on TFNN.
Mimi asks where I think Apple's headed. It's trading out here kind of like a basically in the 115s. I think it probably goes up in the 116s before the end of the day. Still think this thing's probably going to kind of slither on up to about 120. Again, they're going to have a phone, so it's 30 days late. I don't know if you can say a great deal about that, but it's very hard to think that while you might have individual days where it's not doing that well, overall, it's probably going to do extremely well through Christmas. I'm going to say through the first quarter, too. They're going to be able to sell that 5G story fairly well, probably better than most of the other manufacturers. So maybe it doesn't do a whole lot here in the next week or two. But my guess is in the roll-up to the 5G phone. So maybe go sideways for a couple weeks, maybe slightly higher. But my guess is into the rollout and release of the next phone, it's going to be back up in the 125, 130 area, and maybe even much higher come Christmas. You know, everybody's going to go boffo for 5G. And, of course, probably have some apps that can take a care of that. You know, they're not going to be the only one with 5G. So it's going to be a big talking point. But too many phones out there that they have are going to have to be updated. They're losing band connectivity for Sprint and T-Mobile and some of the other ones out there, AT&T. You're going to be forced to upgrade your phone. My guess is if you have an Apple phone, you'll hear all about the 5G and you go, okay, so it's $40 a month, whatever. Put it on my monthly statement and moving on. So I think they're going to do well. I think a lot of those phones that have to be upgraded are going to be, and brand loyalty is something Apple's good at. Am I going to buy any of their stuff? No. I'm more of somebody that reads the spec sheet than the marketing hype. But the people that love their Apple products love their Apple products. Don't think that they're changing anytime soon. Sell when you can, not when you have to. We will return tomorrow.